Hi everyone, my name is Stephanie and I'm part of the high school fellowship at Lutheran Church of the Holy Spirit. I also serve during summer day camp and I just wanted to come on here to remind you guys that this time at home is the perfect time to develop a new skill. You can watch Miss Lorraine's cooking videos or Mr. Nat's art videos, but today I'm bringing you guys a modern calligraphy video. So you can grab some markers and some paper and join me, or you can even just watch and listen to the music and chill with me. So just taking any paper you have, I'm going to be using two different markers today. The first one is this Tombow brush tip marker and just a regular Crayola marker too, whatever you have at home. So the first exercise we're gonna do is thin upward strokes. This is practicing control. And you're also going to practice thicker downward strokes. Again, here I am doing thin upward strokes to practice controlling using a very light touch with your marker and thicker downward strokes on the thicker part of your marker on the diagonal, as you can see here. So moving on to the next exercise, we're going to do some upside down U's. You want to practice using that same light touch, thin strokes on the up and then thicker stroke on the down. You always want to do a thicker downstroke, so we're going to practice doing the U's with a thick downstroke first and then lifting up lightly to do a lighter, thinner upstroke. Now we're going to move on to our next exercise, and that's going to be a continuous squiggly line with those same thin upstrokes and thicker downstrokes. You really want to use the thicker part of your marker so you can get that thick downstroke. Moving on to the fun part, we're gonna do letters. Yay! So starting with our first letter A, same thing. Whenever you go up, you go lightly up with a thin upstroke. But when you go down, you press a little bit harder and you rely on the thicker part of your marker to go down to form that thicker downstroke. Always thick on the down. With the letter B, you wanna create a loop first. So that includes going from the left up, around, and down with a thick downstroke to loop up. C is pretty self-explanatory, so I'm just going to start explaining D. So for D, you want to form the little loop first, and then when I go up, you can see I slightly change the angle of what I'm going up with. Here I'm going to do it again with the blue marker, but you can see that I slightly changed the angle, and that's just making more room for the thicker downstroke. Maybe I should have mentioned this before, but on the left side where I've already written out the letter in gray, you can see I also wrote out the stroke order.
Thank you. missed myself filming the S, so here I am tracing over them. The first two are what I usually do for my S's, but this one is kind of a regular cursive S, and this one is a more loopy S, so it's really up to you. Z's, I just follow what a cursive Z would look like, but if you really wanted to, you could even do a print Z like this.
So that's it, everyone. Thank you for watching. You can slow the video down if you need to look at the letters being written slower to follow. And also with connecting the letters, if you just follow that with the end connecting loop, you'll be able to connect the letters no problem, just as I'm showing here with the A, B, and C. And I just want to remind you guys that it's not going to look perfect the first time around. Here I'm inserting a clip of my first journal and the first time I ever tried modern calligraphy 2 years ago. And as you can see, it looks a little rough and not exactly how it looks today. So just want to encourage you that practice makes progress. And so if you keep practicing with this time you have now, it'll look beautiful in no time. So that's all I have for you guys today. Everyone, remember to stay safe and stay healthy. May God be with you and your family. Bye, everyone.